It is surprising to be to have been doing it for 50 years now. It's a long time.
I'd like to raise my hand and say I never thought we'd be this old.
Good point.
Well, to begin with, I think that if you have the desire to play, and if music is your life, and you're still doing it, and you found a way to keep doing it. A lot of guys, you know, like they don't get called as much as they get older, and then they get less work and they have to take another job. Maybe they don't keep their chops. But the guys that do it because they love it, and because that they're they are better now than they ever were.
I think I'm playing, you know, probably better than I have. Not as fast as I used to, but I think I'm playing better, yeah, with more feel, for sure.
At 25, you're physically at your peak. What happens is something much more profound than having physical dexterity. It's having a deeper, deeper, deeper connection with what you're playing. The physical becomes less and less important. Is it as physically easy to do certain things? No. It's still pretty good, but I can tell, like, oh, that stretch when I was 25 didn't hurt.
There's a live wire, a fuse that runs through, like, a musician. He knows what's good, and he wants to play. You don't have time at this age to waste it. You don't waste your time playing crap or playing something you don't want to play. It doesn't matter to you. You just play what matters.
Pablo Casals, they asked him why he was still practicing in his 90s. And he said, I'm just about to make a breakthrough. Right. That is the exact right answer. You don't quit. You can't quit, and you don't quit when it comes to playing music for guys like us and guys like the immediate family. This is what we do every day, all the time. And nothing, there's no, never a question about, you know, well, I'm done. I don't want to do this anymore. You know, yeah, you do it. You have to do it.